This conference will now be recorded.
So in previous session, we understood when I want to communicate between two org, so I need to authenticate. And in my example, to authenticate what I did from my client org, let me show you. I have used partner whistle, and from partner whistle, I have called my login method, and then I got my session object. From that session object, I have passed session ID with my subsequent call. If you see the previous example, what we did when I am communicating to my server, or I have executed something like this. Okay, now you see that means if my server is Salesforce and I want to integrate with that, so now to get the session informations, the easiest way what we can do, we can get my partner whistle, and then I can invoke my login method, and I can get it, which we did previous examples. So now just consider, is there any other mechanism without invoking or without accessing my partner whistle, or without making the swap invocation call to my login method to get session ID? Is there any other mechanism to do it? So I do not want to use these calls, nothing but I don't want to use this login method call, but I want to get session ID some way to get session ID, and then I want to make a subsequent call. So what are the other mechanism I have to get the session ID? Okay, to understand this, what I'm going to do, I can use simply something called OAuth. I'm just explaining here, it's a very big concept which we have to do in my all upcoming sessions. Okay, so we can make a OAuth mechanism with my SOAP call, which will help me to get session ID from my server, and that session ID I can pass in my subsequent calls. So how we are going to do it? And whenever I want to use this OAuth, before understanding this, we have to understand two concepts. So nothing but we have to understand about connected app. I'll give just a quick intro about connected app, and then I'll talk about to what is OAuth and how this OAuth are going to help me to get session information from server to here. So first, there is something called connected app. So we have to work on the connected app. So what is connected app and how I can use it? Okay, so whenever you have Salesforce org, let me explain it conceptually so that which will help you to understand first. So whenever you have a Salesforce org and you are going to communicate to different systems or different applications, okay, so in between you can use connected app. So nothing but you can say a connected app is like a framework which enable all external applications to integrate with Salesforce using some kind of API, like which I have shown you SOAP API, using maybe API, or maybe using standard protocols, or maybe using our SAML, OAuth, or OpenID Connect. So whatever we can, using that mechanism, the different APIs, different external applications can connect to my Salesforce. So simply you can say it's just a framework which will help me to integrate using some API. So what this connected app framework, or what this connected app going to do for us, it's simply going to authenticate, authorize, and provide single sign on to my external app. So whatever the external applications I have, or whatever the external APIs are there who want to communicate to my Salesforce org, to them, to authenticate them, or to authorize what they can do on my system, or whenever I am going to build any single sign-on, that time I can initiate my connected app to create. Okay, so connected app, nothing but it's a framework which used by the external applications to connect my org. And we have to consider when I need to use my connected app. Okay, so what kind of scenario I may need to look when I want to use connected app. So like see, now also in the previous example, I was able to integrate two system, but I didn't use any connected app. So now what kind of scenario we need to see for that time I have to create a connected app. So what is this connected app which makes external app and Salesforce to integrate, and this with this how I am going to authenticate or authorize them. So now let's see at what time we are going to use the connected app. So basically I will tell four use cases. So whenever these use cases you face, that moment you be sure you have to create a connected app. So whenever you want your data to be accessible with your API integration, that moment you can use connected app. So you have to use connected app to request access to my Salesforce data on behalf of some external applications. Okay, so that time what do you do? So this first point what you see I listed out here, access data with API integration. So you have to make a connected app which is going to request access. Okay, and that connected app must be integrated with Salesforce API using some OAuth mechanism, which I'll talk what is OAuth mechanism. Okay, so the scenario whenever you want to access some data from the Salesforce or okay through API integration, you have to create a connected app in the server. Same way, whenever you are going to integrate service provider with Salesforce org, that moment also you have to do it. What it means, like whenever you want to make Salesforce as a identity provider, okay, or whenever you want to set up any SSO with XAML 2.0, so that moment you have to create a connected app. So you can use connected app with XAML 2.0 to integrate any service provider with the Salesforce org. Okay, for the example of if you want to have another applications, let's consider with my Salesforce org, I have another applications which also web hosted, and I want this application I can access without logging in. Simply I can go from Salesforce, I can access. So I can set up my Salesforce org as a identity provider. And when you have this kind of scenario, your Salesforce org becoming a service provider. Okay, so that moment what you can do, we can create a connected org. You can integrate service provider with Salesforce org. That moment simply you can go and create a connected app. Same way, when you want to manage third party apps, manage access to third party apps, that time also you can create a connected app. So why you want, you can define whenever there is a third party app, it's going to access your org. You can define that third party app can access what kind of data, nothing but your authorization label. You can define what kind of data they can access, or what kind of like who the users are going to use that third party app. We can control that through connected app. Whenever any third party app you want to manage their access label, you can do that through my connected app. For example, to understand, let's see, I have this client org. Okay, let's see, in this client org I want to use my data loader IO. It's a third party app, you can think. Okay, so now if I want to log in with Salesforce, two thing I am going to show here. I click on login. Okay, so now I'm just going to click allow. So now you see my third party app, what I have, it's going to take what kind of information. Okay, this kind of authorization label we can control. So your third party app going to access what. Okay, so that we can control with our connected app. Same way, we can, the same thing here, provide authorization for external API. So like how we define third party apps, if you have any external API call, for that API calls, if you want to control what kind of authorization level they can do, nothing but what kind of scope you are going to define. So to control that also, we can create my connected app. So it's nothing but Salesforce going to act as a OAuth authorization server for any API gateway. So whenever that kind of scenario you have, you can create a connected app. So there are various mechanisms to create a connected app. So once you create connected app, then we can see with the connected app how you are able to make that to authenticate any API calls or to authorize or provide some authorization label to my external apps. So we'll see in the next session how I am going to create a connected app. For my example, what I'm doing, like the previous example, what we did here, instead of working with the SOAP partner still, I will see how I can use OAuth call to get my access token, and then I can invoke my SOAP services. Thank you. Stay tuned for next session.